Welcome to the Grokshop. Today's video is going to be all about hacking SIM cards down. Now, if you need to upgrade your mobile phone or cell phone, you may find that it uses a smaller size SIM card, and there are several SIM card sizes out there. In today's video, I'll be reducing a micro SIM to a nano SIM. Now, of course, the normal process will be to get a new SIM card from your carrier. Some cases you might be able to get them for free, but usually you have to pay. And sometimes you can get an aftermarket one for a little cheaper and then activate it. But this provides a shortcut from the headache and might save you a little money. Start off by removing your SIM card from your old phone. Here I'm using an old iPhone 4. Next, you want to take your new phone and remove the SIM card holder. This phone is a Google Pixel phone. So you want to try inserting the SIM card into the new phone's SIM card tray. Verify that it doesn't fit before you proceed with this. So now, just to illustrate the size difference, I have one of the SIM cards where you can punch out the nano portion from the micro portion, and you can see the size difference here between the two. So of course I could use the template from the punch out to draw the nano SIM boundary onto the micro SIM, but since most of you won't have that, I'm going to use this printout template method. So when you print it out, make sure you're printing on your size printer's paper, so the template should be matched. For example, if you got a letter printer, you want to have a letter template, and then you need to print to actual size. And then you can use some calipers if you have them. You need to measure the distances shown on the printout so that they're exactly correct. You can also use a ruler to get pretty close, close enough for the purposes of this anyway. Okay, next you need to use some double-sided tape to attach the micro SIM to the template. I use some 3M little wall hanger tape thingies. It really doesn't matter as long as it's stuck on there really good. You want to have the contact side facing up just as shown in the picture there. And make sure that the SIM is positioned exactly within the boundaries shown on the template. Next, you want to take a Sharpie or some other form of permanent marker and a ruler and mark along the boundaries on the outside of where the cuts are indicated, so that basically you'll be cutting away the areas that are marked with the Sharpie. So should look kind of like this when you're done. One thing to be aware of is that little dot in the top middle there. Notice that the corner cut bevel key is below and to the right of that. When you're done cutting, you'll be left with nothing but these contacts in the chip area. And so it's possible to get disoriented if you don't keep that straight. Okay, next we can pull the SIM up off the template, remove the tape from the SIM. And here I'm just going to bring over that little template from the punch out SIM I had. Just check how well I drew these guides on here. All right, so next it's time to bust out the scissors. I recommend some good sharp ones. It's really not that difficult to cut, but when it's sharp, you can get nice clean edges. I recommend cutting it a little fat, cut just to the outside of the marker, leave just a little bit of black behind, or whatever color your marker is. And that way, when you're done trimming with the scissors, you can come back with a file and file it down just so it fits nice and snug inside that SIM tray. Okay, next it's time to bust out the files. I tried quite a few different types of files and had some varying degrees of success. Main thing is you want something kind of mild. You don't want anything too brutish. You could use sandpaper, maybe a 220 grit or higher. And the key of it all is going to be just taking a little bit of material off each edge at a time, and then going back to your template or your tray and seeing if it fits in there okay, and looking at where you need to take more material off, and just keep working down each edge until it fits in there nice and snug. Once you get the SIM to where it fits nice and snug in the tray, be sure to clean it off, dust it off a little bit. Last thing you want is getting some SIM dust in your phone. That's how it's done. Thanks for watching.